Consignment Shop. Seeing all these purses and having the store to myself, how could I not stop and check out all these purses and do a purse rummage while I'm here? These look interesting enough, so I think I will just grab a chair and sit down and look through these with and for y'all, okay? Alright, so I'm in a chair now and getting comfortable. This is a $29 Michael Kors bag. What interesting features does this have? Well, this is not too easy to work with. One inside pocket. Two inside pockets. There's another couple on the side, on the inside. Okay, it's a pretty straightforward purse. Keeping in mind that this is a secondhand shop, some of these are probably going to have either damage or wear and tear on them. Alright, this one. Oh, it looks like there's several Vera Bradley purses. It's kind of an orangey red. Inside has a green. This room has, this particular room where the purses are, has a greenish hued light. So some of these items are not going to look quite their normal color. Okay, $15 for this one. Lots of pockets inside this one too. They seem like deep pockets too, which really, really helps someone like me. Here's a paisley Vera Bradley. $15 for that one. I love the pink. Wow, look at all those pockets. You know, if you're gonna have just a big old open purse, it really helps to have a bunch of little compartments like that. Interesting, this kind of looks like a beach bag. Well, you know, sandals on the outside, but I mean the shape of it. Ooh, she's written the price on the inside. $3.99. I think sometimes Melissa, the store owner, does that with certain items that she thinks are not as high quality. I don't know if it comes off or not. I think this is just a fun beach bag, you know. A few pockets on the inside. appreciate about the Portland Consignment Shop is that everything's always clean. Always clean. And neat and organized. Quite a cut above thrift shops, typical ones. Little matching coin purse is a nice feature. I like that little bag. That's sweet. Flip-flops. Let's get another one. Sequins that go both ways. Reversible sequins. Okay. And then the idea is that putting it right says wolf. I don't know about this, guys. I don't know what we're trying to tell people here. Am I a dog? Or do I like dogs? Someone's gonna make fun of me if I wear that. Oof. It's very pretty though. Very shiny, sparkly. Love it. I can tell you right now, I am not going to buy a purse. I have no idea what this is. Ooh, I'm not going to read the word out loud because I want to be a family-friendly channel. Okay, ooh, that pink is hot, hot pink. Beautiful. This purse definitely has some wear and tear on the edges of it. Yeah, because I think it is an inexpensive vinyl. It's kind of cute though. This one's so interesting. Definitely meant to be a purse. but I don't know. Okay, we got a black something or other. It's just a small little pocketbook. When I think of pocketbooks, this is what I think of because it's about the size of a pocket. A pocket. Could probably hold more than this purse. Okay, so the ribbon goes all the way through. It's just a decoration and it's not a pocket. And it's a nice long shoulder strap. Over the head. What do you call them? I'm having a big brain fart. Okay, $20 for baby fat backpack. Now, this is very interesting. Studs on the outside. Whoa, look at those stripes. Blue and white stripes. And there are two main compartments with inside pockets. Somebody left some notepads, sticky pads in there. Let's just leave that there. Pockets are not very deep, and that's a problem for me. I like to stick a pair of sunglasses or my cell phone on the inside pockets of my purse. Well, let's see. This also has a snap closure. And I love that it's a backpack. Is that not the coolest? See, that's the kind of purse I carry most of the time. That's sweet. A small handle that's very stout, and backpack straps. I'd be really tempted to get this one. Discipline today. I'm gonna be good. This is so interesting. It's sort of just like another beach bag. Only it's got this really fancy kind of gold lame. Sewing. Very sturdy, nice, actual kind of just bag. I like it. Over the... Okay, guys, help me with what the terminology is for purses that go over your head. This is a cute little, it's probably just like a little cigarette case or something for somebody. Although it looks like it holds, I don't know, this looks like perfect size for a pack of cigarettes and a lighter and some ID. For some people, that's all they need. Okay. Shopping bags, heart, soul, scrubs.com, scrubs, oh, so if you bought a set of scrubs, if you're a nurse, and they might have sent it to you in this bag, or this is a compliment great bag that they send with if you order some scrubs. I don't know, just guessing. I like colors. Cosmetic. I guess that would also be the same thing. Complimentary bag. If you buy it from LA Colors. Gorgeous. Beautiful blue. So this is another one of those that goes over your head. Oh, that's what it's called. Cross body. Oh my goodness. $3.99. This is just a simple knitted or crocheted. I can't tell which that is. Knitted, it looks like. So these days, crossbody purses is what I'm enjoying. Sassy shape. Because it just feels more secure from theft and such. And it does kind of leave you hands-free if you just want to leave it hanging there by your side or over your shoulder. This is a cute little pouch. And another one that she wrote the price in. If I were younger, I'd be drawn to that. And it's a crossbody chain. Yeah, I like that. Very youthful, I think. But I'm not into gold. Put some things back here. As I'm looking through these purses, I'm kind of resting them on the ground lightly. There we go. All right, that's organized for now. A knot in that one so it would stay up a little higher. Okay. I want to look through some other purses. This one. It's so interesting because it folds however it was made. Can't even read that. 96 or something. It's so shiny I couldn't even make out the letters and numbers. See, it doesn't go all the way through though, even though it's one. Interesting. so cleverly made. So then they join up on the sides and then clasp in the middle. Now this looks very, I don't know, vintage to me. This is just one inside pocket. I say vintage, but I'm thinking maybe even not even that long ago, but it just okay. See, it's divided into two. Oh, okay. That's interesting enough. I think it would be functional, but so kind of outdated in my opinion. But I don't know. I mean, you know, I'm 61 years old, but I still have my opinion about some purses looking like a grandma purse, and I don't even know where I get that idea from. This is very in extraordinary, not extraordinary, but has a body strap, so it would work. I just needed something small, simple, understated. Same thing with this. Just a little black bag. And the other pocket book doesn't look quite like a purse. Grab another one here. See, they're all tangled. Okay, this is very interesting. Fanny pack that's made of vinyl type of plastic. And it's a like an opalescent hot pink combination. Yes, I'd use something like that. Alright, this, I don't know. It makes me think of a bowling bag. If this is a purse, I don't know. No offense, anybody. I like eagles, but this purse lacks imagination. Alright. Now this is so fascinating. $20 puzzle. Now look at this. I want to say it's corrugated, but that's not the right term for it's interwoven layers on the outside, and it's like a canvas on the inside. I like it. It seems quality, but I honestly cannot tell whether that's real leather or not. Sure looks like it to me. I like it. I think it's very well made. Now this one, I love, love it. But it might be too small for me. Looks like real leather. A lot of compartments. Looks like it's going to have a place for your monies and credit cards. Yes, indeed. There is a little wallet. A little... Wow, just the whole works. You could have your whole... financial setup in there. And if something, the wallet just tucks in there. Yes, back. The wallet just tucks in there. Oh, okay, good. Okay, I am having some little bit of difficulty. Look, though, that is very substantial construction. Love it. It's got an appeal of its own. Just one tiny little strap. She won't take it. This purse is in the way. Just get it situated. I want to show you this tiny little blue all-in-one. Buckle. $50. Yeah. It's a decent little purse. I like it. I think it's stylish in its shape and size. Maybe a bit too small for me. And this purse is just wild, wild. Look at these designs. Oh, here's who it's by. Fossil. She wants $21.99. Now, I just rarely buy things new, so I don't even recognize the name Fossil. I don't know anything. Inside it's kind of a canvasy, and the outside's like this vinyl, so that's an interesting contrast. These colors, it's wild, I'm really drawn to it actually. If I saw somebody using a purse like this, I would definitely compliment them. Of course, I tend to just compliment strangers on whatever I see that I like. Here we go. Set that aside. I used to work at a convenience station. Cheer people up by just commenting on whatever struck me as being noteworthy. Look at this. This is this. But see, then, now this is like the cross between a grandma purse and a stylish, well-made purse. This is really, it's actually kind of heavy. It's weighty because it's made of this amazing material. I don't recognize that emblem, logo, whatever that is. Okay, and this is just a tiny little crossbody. It's like a burnt orange, brown inside. That lovely crunchy sound. It's clean, like burnt orange. Interesting. $10, and it says crossbody on it. Oh, the tag, I mean. That's a convenient little pocketbook. But anyway, sometimes... Oh, here's another fossil. I would... some people would just be so amazingly shocked when I would tell them, "You have beautiful eyes," or "I love your hair style," or whatever, you know. I never said anything that wasn't true. $15 for a rather basic purse. A tiny zipper. You can pull that right out and clean it if you had to. But it's very basic. I don't think it's leather. I think that's vinyl, but it sure looks like leather. Someone would have to look twice to really know. The strap's long enough to be crossbody. Kinda like it. Anyway, if I see somebody with a beautiful purse, I will just tell a stranger, you know, that's gorgeous. Hey, here's another fold up. And it has that little enclosure. It's very retro. Comes up. Oh, look here. Okay, so this one's attached by the pocket on the inside. This is very, very appealing to me. Very appealing. No clue why, I guess, because I'm just really into $5.99. Justice. Oh, Justice. That is very popular young people's name brand. Okay, these zippers are proving very difficult to work with. They're tucked in. Very youthful. Yeah, that makes sense. That's probably why I like it. Ooh. I love this red. And the bag's kind of... Yeah, cares. Money, money, money. And it's a $2 bill on the front of all things. $2 bill. Ooh. That is really pretty. This tells you something about me, if I like this kind of purse. It would not serve any purpose for me. I'd sooner use it as a cosmetic bag, but it's crossbody. It's well made. I remember the Rosetti bags from, is it Kmart? My son cracked me up one day years and years ago. When he said, "Oh, you got a new purse from Kmart?" And I'm like, "What? Kmart." It's like, there was this joke about how the things that you get from Kmart are not quality, and I didn't know. Oh, that's so funny. Kmart. Oh gosh. No insult intended. I used to work at Kmart years and years ago when I was a teenager. I miss being able to go there because we don't have any more out here. It's very exciting, except for that little tassel. I like that. It's cute. Crossbody. Alright, Jan. Maybe it's inside here. Oh, there it is. It's a pencil. That's cute. I like it. Alright, let's get this thing to put back on me. Now that I have found the prize. something I like. This is crossbody or short if you want it. The mirror, it's sort of like a very functional purse slash cosmetic bag. Interesting. And it even labels everything for you. Interesting. Call me. That's kind of cutesy, actually. So that chain on the outside could be shortened or lengthened, depending on what you like. I like that. Sort of the color of watermelon. Watermelon red. Here's a similar type of purse that has a gold and silver combination of colors. And gold on the inside. Okay, and this is very vinyl. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, so I have seen many purses here that I like. So just get them all tucked back and definitely put away. I see purses here I would have bought if that were in my budget, but it's not my agenda today. So many cute things, I just think I'd get, you know, if hey, thought I was done, and this purse showed up at my feet, $5, what an interesting purple, lilac. $15 for it. What's this? There's these. Oh my goodness. Oh, okay. So I think this is an exchangeable purse. Like, I'll show you. You can just undo the cover. See, take that off and then replace it with the other two patterns that are in there. That is fascinating. Never seen that concept before for a woman's pocketbook purse situation. There's another one in here. Less bright and extraordinary, but how interesting. Hey guys, I'm done. Thank you for joining me for my purse rummage.